Thank you. National Opera Center's Skorka Hall right here in Manhattan. It's our only concert in Manhattan all season. Most of the time we're out playing in senior centers, libraries. We've played at the Queens Botanical Garden. And most of the time in Queens, although we've done some outreach in Brooklyn this year. The next piece on the program, it means a lot to me. Arturo Marquez is probably best known for his Danza No. 2. And you probably have heard it. It's such a popular piece. Dudamel, the wonderful conductor, Gustavo Dudamel, conducted the Simon Bolivar Youth Orchestra on tour doing that piece. And they did it so many times. They did it in the US, and people started hearing it. Other orchestras started playing it. And it's so much fun. It's just a wonderful, that danzón Mexican feel. It's not the Cuban danzón, it's like a Mexican. We were in Cuba in November for the International Contemporary Music Festival, and we had the wonderful opportunity on the very last concert of the festival to hear a premiere for orchestra and flute. It was like a flute solo concerto by Arturo. And afterwards, Matt and I ran down to the stage to get our picture taken with him. And since then, I've emailed him that we were playing his piece many times this spring. He said, I wish I could be there. Much success, big hugs. So here we are about to play it. It's basically, it means the dance at noon. And you have basically two kinds of things going on. You have this sort of laid back, you know, afternoon, easygoing thing. And then you have that more energetic dance, and it goes back and forth. So, danza del mediodia.
Thank you. Thank you. So we've been playing concerts in Queens to audiences that are less experienced than some of our other audiences. And we pride ourselves in bringing new work to the seniors, to young adults, to all kinds of people all over Queens, and in some cases, Brooklyn. The next piece is one that we commissioned several years ago. It's called Ventos, as you see in the program. It's on our CD called Colors of Brazil.
Sounds
of Brazil.
Which is for sale out in the lobby.
Yes, there we go. So in trying to help people listen to this piece, which is actually quite listenable, that it has a motor rhythm, and it's a minimalist piece. It kind of sails along. In some ways, it's like galloping through a landscape that changes. And it is literally, in some ways, the winds, and represents the wind. The wind that changes direction, that kind of comes to a standstill and waits, and then goes again. So we're very happy to play Ventos for you.
Thank you. Thank you. compositions, and it's an exciting time for us to play new music, of course. We are fortunate enough to have two composers with us tonight, pieces that they've written for us that we're going to play. The first piece is called, well, I'm going to let her explain it to you. Xinyan. Oh, this is Jim.
Yes.
Oh, I have the total wrong thing. This is wrong.
Maybe you turned too many pages.
Well, the same thing goes for what I was going to say. We have two wonderful composers here tonight. And this young gentleman here, we've known for many, many years and have played many of his pieces. And he lives in Queens, where we, of course, do a lot of outreach work and so forth in concerts. Would you like, Jim Cohen, to say a couple of words about your piece?
Sourwood Mountain. And the reason it's called Sourwood Mountain is the fruits of the tree are very much enjoyed by the birds, but to the settlers, when they tasted the fruits, they found them to be bitter and sour. So that's why that mountain is called Sourwood Mountain. The early settlers liked to dance. They were, most of them, not in cities or towns, and they needed to hire a musician to provide them with music. They could not afford to buy a group of musicians. It was usually one musician to supply all of the melody and the rhythm and the everything else. So it was usually probably a fiddler. And this man, who provided the music, would every once in a while raise his voice, holding his instrument, and sing something or other in the same rhythm, and the thing that he improvised was the poem, Chickens crowing on Sourwood Mountain. Oh, down doodle diddle all the day. So many pretty girls, I can't count them. Oh, down doodle city all the day. That is the melody, and I have put together a set of variations on this little ditty. Thank you.
My woodwind quintet, Mosul Sparrow Ceremony, is inspired by the unique funeral custom in Mosul, a minority in southwest of China. In this work, the first section, Lama, depicts the descriptions, the scriptures to release the souls. And the second section, Daba monks dance to expel the souls. The third section, Lama burns the corpse for reincarnation. I really appreciate the hard efforts by Quintet America. They pay a lot of efforts for my music, and thanks for coming for enjoying the concert. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
you're about to hear a piece by a rock pop group called Owl City. They're shaking their heads, some of these people. They know all about this guy. He's great. Adam Young, he's also a bassoonist in the group, and he wrote a fantastic piece called Fireflies. He's described the piece as a little song about bugs and not being able to fall asleep at night. He told us to picture a little boy in his room on a hot summer night looking out the window, and he can't fall asleep. He said it's really a song built around insomnia and turning from a kid to an adult and the trouble some of us have in that transition. Lying awake all night with hundreds and hundreds of fireflies all buzzing around you, lit up. So if you can picture that, well, that's what we're about to play.
Thank you. National Opera Center. And just a little bit of a personal note, this is my first season with the group, as is it Sasha's, and it's been such a wonderful experience. Very importantly, we have a reception after the performance tonight. We'd really love for you all to join us for some food and some drink and get to know each other a little bit better. So that'll be immediately following. The finale we have is by a wonderful composer by the name of Valerie Coleman. She came to fame as the founding flutist of the Amani Wind Quintet, which is quite possibly the most well-known woodwind quintet out there today. She's no longer in the group, and she is fervently composing. She composes for the woodwind quintet group, as well as many other types of ensembles. Tzigane was a little bit of a revelation for me. I've known her music. I've performed other pieces with the quintet previously, and I kind of associated her more with a jazz feel, some African influence, that sort of thing. And this piece has a totally different taste to it. It's Middle Eastern in influence. It still has her signature melodic lines and a very rhythmic piece, almost danceable through much of it. And lucky for me, she left a very open clarinet cadenza in the middle of the piece. So it's improvised, it's based on the harmonies and scales of this type of music. For those of you kind of more familiar with the language, it's a mode that kind of lowers the second scale degree and the sixth and seventh while leaving the major third in there, creating kind of an augmented second that gives it its kind of distinct quality of sound. So thank you again for being here. Valerie Coleman, Tzigane.
Thank you. Thank you.